Once a long time ago, up here in the Strath of Kildonan, the people at this broch were under threat. They actually lived in small homes surrounding the broch, and the broch site here, the huge stone tower, was a place of safety that they could go to when they were under attack. And one time they were under attack from the Norsemen. It's about 1200 years ago the Vikings first landed in Helmsdale, and they quickly scattered and moved up the Strath of Kildonan. We can imagine the war bands quickly moving up there, clearing everything as they went, people running and screaming and livestock scattering in front of them. The people here at the broch would have known that the best thing to do would have been to get inside the broch, grab as much food and water as they can and their precious children, and get inside the broch and shut the huge stone door. And that's what they did. The Viking war band quickly scrabbled up the hills in front of us here. And we can imagine them climbing over the bank there and standing right on the flat bit below the broch. And they taunted and shouted at the warriors on top of the broch. And the warriors answered them back, because they were not afraid at that point. They were in safety. But days passed, weeks passed, and very quickly the people inside the broch here were going hungry and thirsty. The Viking war leader as well was getting a bit bored, so he decided he would set them a challenge. If they could send a messenger, the most important person that they had in the broch, to meet him, then he would release the women and the children. But the men must die, the warriors inside must die. They quickly got together to discuss this, and they sat around looking at the people in the broch and all the different things that they'd done for the clan, for the tribe. They looked at the medicine woman. She was very important. She cured them when they were sick. She delivered their healthy babies. They looked at the ancient old one, who dealt with their religion and knew about the stones and the ancient burials. And he guided their spirits. And then they turned and they looked into the corner. No. And then they turned and they looked towards their strongest warrior. He was the one who took their warbands out and he offered them protection. He was best at the hunt and he could supply their food. But none of them were quite right. Then they turned and they looked. In the corner where the children were sleeping, there was a small boy, a little two-year-old lad with blonde hair. And then it all struck them. He was the messenger. He was the person that was their future. It was a long night in the broch that night. Every woman knew that this was the last night she would spend with her man. Every woman wanted to be pregnant when she left to carry on the clan. And every woman knew as she stepped out, they rolled the stone back, she would have to say farewell to her partner. And this is what they would have to do if they accepted the boy as the messenger. The stone was rolled back. The two-year-old boy was pushed out. We can imagine he would have been a bit scared, but he toddled on quite bravely towards the Viking war band and, of course, the Viking chieftain. They went forward and he looked at the chieftain. We can imagine him gazing up at this tall, blonde-haired man with a thick beard, clad in leather, wearing silver jewellery. He had his leather on his axe strings swinging above the boy's head. He was holding on to his weapons tightly, and he gazed down to the top of this boy's head because it was just as the sun was starting to come over in the dawn, and the sun hit the boy's fair hair. And the Viking war leader nodded his head. They had indeed put out the most important messenger that they had, the two-year-old boy, because he was their future. All the other people dealt with their present. So the Viking war leader shouted to the top of the broch, "The messenger is accepted. The women and children can leave." And so it was. And that is the way the story ended. The women and children had to leave the broch. Of course, the warriors from the broch here were executed, but they preserved their future. And that was the most important thing.